everyone, this is Nico Carver. I recently bought this new camera from Canon called the Canon EOS Ra, which is Canon's first full-frame camera for astrophotography. And it's also mirrorless, meaning it's a bit more compact and lighter than my full-frame DSLRs. And I wanted to do a quick video here with my first impressions and mainly to explain why I bought this camera over some of the other exciting options that are available today. If you stick around to the end of the video, I'll show you my first light, meaning the first image I've taken with this camera. And I just took it the other night. It's of the Orion and Running Man nebulae. Okay, first off, this is not necessarily a reason to buy a camera, but the box is pretty darn cool. Look at this. This is the California Nebula featured right here. It's on the front and on the side. And I just thought, like, what a nice, clean, cool image to put on your camera box. Okay, so my main reason for buying this camera is I wanted an upgrade to my Canon 5D Mark III, which is what I'm shooting with right now. And I wanted to use it for a bit of everything, making videos like this one, astrophotography, obviously, both with telescopes and with camera lenses. And I wanted to use it as my everyday shooter. What I mean by an everyday shooter is daytime, you know, just around the town, just taking pictures of nature and people and all that kind of stuff. And the great thing for me, and this might not apply to you, but going from a 5D Mark III to the RA is all of my existing lenses and speed lights and even battery packs, everything works directly with this camera. So instead of having to rebuy a bunch of accessories when getting a new camera, I can go straight from the 5D to the RA, hopefully sell my 5D, and everything will just work. But now I'm mirrorless, which has a lot of advantages. One of them being that the flange distance to the sensor is much, much shorter. So I can adapt many more lenses to this system than I could with my 5D, where the sensor was further back into the camera body because the mirror had to be in front. It took me a while to come to this conclusion of getting an all-arounder. My first thought when I was thinking about camera upgrades was to get specialized cameras for everything. If you're in the video world, you might know about Blackmagic Cinema Camera for making videos. I was thinking of a Nikon camera for travel and lens-based astrophotography, and then keeping my Canon 5D for everyday shooting. But I realized, though, that this camera, the Canon EOS RA, could do all of those things, and all of them pretty well. So my plan is to sell my 5D Mark III, sell my Nikon D800, and save money in the long run by not having to buy all new lenses and accessories. So while the main thing that I heard about this camera is that it's just too expensive, for me, looking at all my options, this was actually a very good value as an all-rounder. Let's look at a few of the ways I'll use this camera that I just talked about and why it makes sense for me. You might already know this, but what makes this camera different than the Canon R, what makes it special for astrophotography, is they factory install a different UV-IR cut filter that lets in the HA and S2 emission lines, but still cuts out the infrared, the IR. This is similar to modifying a DSLR, except you don't have to worry about breaking your warranty since it comes pre-modified. The only other thing that makes this camera different from the Canon EOS R is when you were in live view, instead of going from 5x zoom to then 10x zoom, as most Canon cameras do, this one goes 5x, then 30x zoom. And I actually wasn't sure how much I'd like this till I tried it. And for me, it was just amazing. It worked great at all the focal lengths I work at for fine-tuning focus with a Bodenov mask, and it just works perfectly. I really liked it. If you're really, really high focal length, the 30x might be too far zoomed in. So I've heard some people say they wish that Canon had put in like 5x, 15x, 30x. Maybe, I'd like that too. So I won't say that Canon shouldn't do that. Maybe they should. I'm not really holding out hope for a lot of firmware updates for this camera because Canon usually doesn't do that, but we'll see. One thing that is missing from it, and I'll go more into negatives when I do a full review after I've had this for a while, is it doesn't have any kind of built-in intervalometer. So it can, you know, it can go up to a 30-second shot, or no, it can actually do a single long exposure because it has a built-in bulb timer, but it doesn't have a built-in intervalometer. So you can't do like a series of 5-minute shots unless you have an external intervalometer or you're using a laptop. So that's one drawback. Another thing that you might not think about when buying a DSLR, but I actually think now it's very important, is it has a flippy screen. So if I were going to do some like vlogging style content with this or filming myself, I can have it pointed towards me. But the flippy screen, I sort of, you know, don't think of that initially as like a big factor in buying a camera, but it actually did play a big part in my decision when it comes to the next use I'll talk about, which is for travel and lens-based astrophotography. My biggest complaint about my current camera for that purpose, for travel and lens-based astrophotography, the Nikon D800, is the lack of a flippy screen. It has what's called a fixed screen into the camera body like this, and I'm just getting really tired of laying on the cold ground to frame my shots when doing astrophotography without a laptop, which I usually don't use a laptop when traveling. So with this flippy screen, what I can do is I can just point it up like this. The camera can be at any angle and I can still frame and see my shot. For making videos, I got very spoiled in my last job. I was a multimedia librarian. I had access to a Canon C100, which is one of their cinema cameras. And it has a bunch of features for video that make it much better than my 5D Mark III. The dual pixel autofocus, which was the first implementation of continuous autofocus while shooting video that actually worked perfectly for me. I'm not using autofocus right now because this is a Canon 5D Mark III, so it's manual focus. So if I hold something up like that, it'll probably be out of focus. Because there's a certain focal plane here where it's in focus. So when I'm holding up stuff like this, I have to keep it fairly close to my face. That's not an issue with the Canon EOS Ra or Canon cinema cameras because they have dual pixel autofocus. So it continually can rack the focus if you're using a Canon lens. Pretty cool. The second cinema feature I really wanted was Canon Log, which is a color profile that you put in the camera and then you apply a color grade in post-processing, and it makes your footage more cinematic because you're starting out at a more sort of log, flat color profile, and then you can stretch it while retaining a lot of shadow detail and stuff like that. One feature I want to briefly mention about this camera that hasn't been getting a lot of attention is that Canon has this official adapter for drop-in filters. So basically what this adapter does is you put it on there, then any EF lens you have from any maker, you can put it on here and you still have full autofocus capability, full control over the iris. But it has this little slot for drop-in filters. Canon has officially only released, neutral density filters and like a clear filter, but there are already manufacturers for astronomy that are making other cool astronomy filters for this drop-in filter system. So I have one right here. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm looking forward to. This is the IDAS Nebula Booster 2, NB2DR. And this lets in the HA and O3 emissions while blocking out most of everything else. The cool thing here is I can just slide this right into the adapter here. It locks into place really satisfyingly. If I need to switch out to like a clear or something like that, it's really just as easy as letting out this little locking pin and putting in a clear. And all while this is all attached to a telescope or attached to a camera lens, it's very easy to switch out filters with this system, which I have not seen if you're like trying to like put a 2-inch filter into a focuser or something like that. So this is actually a pretty cool innovation that I don't think a lot of people are talking about. And I hope other filter makers like Optolong and Astronomic develop filters for this drop-in system too, now that the Canon EOS Ra is out. because it's really, really slick. Last thing I'll say, part of making this decision for me is just what feels right. And I've been using Canon cameras for over a decade, and I just like them. For me, the ergonomics are always right on. They just really know how to do a grip and where to put the buttons and that kind of thing. The menus are always amazing. I don't get lost in the menus. And then lastly, for like daytime and this kind of photography, skin tone and stuff like that, I think the colors are typically better than what I see from other camera makers. I am impartial though. I'll try any cameras because I'm a camera nut. I've tried Sony, I've tried Panasonic, Fuji, Nikon, even Olympus, and nothing has ever felt as right in my hands as a Canon camera. I'm not paid by them. I have no affiliation, but I just love Canon cameras. But I totally get that others feel the same way that I do about Canon, but for Nikon or Sony or Fuji. So I'll just leave you with this. Specs aren't everything. It's more about what you do with the camera as a photographer. And with that said, as a treat for people who stayed to the end of the video, here's my first light with the camera. This is just under an hour, just about 30 sub-exposures at 90 seconds each. And it's the Orion and Running Man Nebula. Okay, till next time, clear skies, everyone. If you're interested in buying the Canon EOS Ra, I'll put my affiliate link in the description. And please subscribe. You can also support me on Patreon. I've been getting a lot of new patrons on Patreon, which I really, really appreciate for doing these videos and keeping to a schedule. All right, thanks.